The big bosses at corporate media giant MSNBC are trying to break up a newly formed union. Further proof that the network isn't as left-leaning as viewers want to believe. Farron Cousins from Trial Lawyer magazine joins me to talk about this. You know, to me, there's no surprise.
Right.
I looked at this story, and it's all the talking points that we see with all union busters. They may not look like union busters today, but I can promise you this. They've hired union busters, haven't they?
Oh, absolutely. You know, and MSNBC, of course, is owned by Comcast, massive, you know, mega corporation. And so the bosses at MSNBC have to do what the corporate leaders are wanting them to do. So you have these employees who back in June joined the Writers Guild of America East. Then the big bosses say, well, now hold up. Before we recognize this, we want to submit it to the National Labor Relations Board. So now you've got until, I think, August 17th, they're going to be doing meetings, they're going to be holding talks, basically trying to kill the union. And what we know, thanks to leaked audio, is that they've already had one town hall where all the big bosses, including the CEO, Rashida Jones, came out and said, guys, why are you doing this?
Yeah.
We're family here.
Well, it's the same talking point that you always see. We're family. Why bring in these people to complicate things? It's going to cost you money. It's going to run employees away. It's not fair to those people who don't want to pay dues. But the most important move is the labor board. Statistically, if they can get it to the labor board, they have time to regroup, don't they?
Yeah.
They have time to put all of the flying monkeys together and really do harm to this effort. And all these folks want, they want higher pay, they want equity, they want diversity. They want what any worker should want, right?
Yeah, exactly. And this is a lot kind of like what we saw in Alabama with Amazon, which, by the way, that's actually going up for review. They may have another vote on that one. So we got to stay tuned to that. But anyway, Amazon came into Alabama, spends thousands of dollars every day on these union-busting law firms using the exact same tactics that MSNBC is using right here. You know, oh, we got to shift it to the NLRB. They've got to handle this. And again, it did give them time to strategize, to get their lawyers out there, to kind of start pressuring people to not join the union. And that is exactly what's happening at MSNBC.
The worst thing about it is this. Every time you have MSNBC in a fight, it's almost like we're the left progressives. You can count on us to be different. As a matter of fact, you'll see MSNBC go to attack maybe Boeing if they're trying to put a union together. But now it's come home, and what they've done, and if I were an employee right now, I'd ask this simple question. Have you hired a PR group that's going to work with the labor board to destroy our union? You know, these folks don't even know. They've already done this, and it didn't come up at the town hall meeting. They've already hired these folks.
Right. And another thing that came up at the town hall, in addition to the, you know, the family talking points, is this: the executives were trying to make it sound like, listen, I've always been approachable. I've always had an open door policy. If you've got a problem, you can come and talk to me. You don't need this union. You know, we were going to give you these things that you're wanting anyway. It's total BS. If they were going to do these things, they would have done them.
Well, more important, the real telltale is this. They said to MSNBC, would you please voluntarily recognize us as union?
Right.
And anybody can do that. Yeah, we could if they were serious about this. But look, this is run. The leadership is no different from that little freak that used to run. What's Phil Griffin? It's all about money. They used to kill story after story that I tried to do when I appeared on MSNBC because advertisers wouldn't let them tell the story. It is so upside down. But nevertheless, you have viewers saying, wow, these people think just like me. They don't.